In 2018, Kasanda passed an ordinance in education in which parents are supposed to provide meals like porridge at break time and food at lunch. As the district leaders gathered to mark 1 year in office since they started service last year, they have embarked on efforts to ensure that this ordinance is implemented. Speaking at a prayer meeting held at the district headquarters in Kasanda town, Kasiria Zimura, the district LC5 chairperson, says they have realized that hunger is one of the major reasons why students perform poorly in schools.
Education is a problem in Kasanda. People are not, you know, children are not passing. The old schools are in a sorry state. So we are trying to rehabilitate them, mostly those government schools.
Kasiria also highlighted tax exemptions for some traders to boost business in the district.
It's not fair at all for someone who has a capital of 50,000 shillings to pay taxes of 360,000 shillings. That is what it means if one is paying 1,000 shillings every day for a small business. Now, we have decided as a district that these small entrepreneurs should have a taxi holiday.
Rex Sembusi, the Secretary for Education, called upon parents to take this campaign in good faith and follow what is being directed.
We made research and found it that the schools that have performed very well provide meals to their children. They give extra lessons to their children. When you look at the performance of Kasanda, the meals are not availed in the schools. So we are calling upon parents, we are mobilizing them, we are sensitizing them on the role of feeding their children. It will, in the short run, help us curb the issue of ulcers that are affecting our children.
Aruna Kamba, the chief administrative officer, urged parents to invest in education for their children. Kamba also cited the sub-counties which are getting modern secondary schools and the existing primary which is getting better facilities like buildings, latrines and other properties.
As a district and the people of Kasanda, we are celebrating today for those achievements. The district is developing very fast and the people are appreciating the service delivery which is being rendered to them as a result of attaining the district status.
The councillors noted a challenge of funds that has limited their service delivery.
We have a challenge of budget cuts. Now we are going in a financial year coming July 2022-2023. That budget, the money which we were calling the DEG, is being scrapped off.
Pastor John Noah Msasizi from Praise Pentecostal Church in Bukuya asked leaders to serve diligently while in office.
Whatever service you're doing to the public, you must always put God first, because God himself chose you, and because he thought that you would be faithful, he's always able to supply to you. He is always able to provide to you. So when you're serving people, have the heart of God.
This report was compiled by Luke Kajiri for the news.